They said, yeah, you know, first year is like you're going up this hill, second year down the hill, third year up the hill, and then you end downhill, which I'm like, great, this is good. It pretty much went uphill and then up more second year. And like, I'm studying a lot right now because we're about to take the boards. Pretty much anything anyone wants to talk about right now is the board. I was trying to enjoy my breakfast this morning, and one of my roommates came up, and she was talking about how she was going to fail the boards. And we all know she's not going to fail the boards. And I just get kind of tired of hearing that because, you know, I don't know. It's a lot of pressure on us right now because we're the first class to come through. The boards is supposed to be a reflection of what you learned in the first 2 years. So it's either we learned a lot or we didn't learn a lot. A little pressure. You don't want to burn out, obviously, but I mean, the boards are kind of a big deal. I guess you can find a little humor in it. So I was seeing a patient, and she was a younger patient. She was texting while driving, which is terrible. I guess she had a car accident and was telling me the story and blah, blah, blah. And then I get to her social history and I'm like, do you use any illicit drugs? She said, yeah, I smoke marijuana. And then people start to trust you with everything. When you ask them these questions, they feel obligated to tell you because you're their provider. But they also know that, like, that isn't going to get out to anybody else. Apparently her mom that was in the room didn't know that she smoked marijuana often. So she was a little surprised by that, and it was very evident that the mom was surprised. The mom was looking at her, she was looking at me, feeling the mom looking at her. It was really bad. I was like, wow, next question. We always say this about Dr. Lucas, and you know, I don't mind telling him or whatever, but anytime we're rotating, doing rotations with Dr. Lucas, you know, we have nurses coming up to us saying like, we're doing rotations with a guy. Dr. Lucas is a legend. You need to respect him. You need to realize who you're walking around with today. You better be so lucky that you're with Dr. Lucas today. It's like a little overwhelming at times because it's like every nurse we pass in the hospital knows him, talks to him. And so we have some amazing doctors that just like their humor just cracks me up. I like Dr. Caius because that's who I have right now, just because like we'll use all these baseball metaphors for like seeing patients or whatever. And he's like, oh, are you up to bat today? Like, yeah, I'm up to bat. The pitcher being the patient. I hope the pitcher doesn't throw a curveball or something like that. Do you drink alcohol? Do you eat healthy? Yes, I eat everything healthy. Do you smoke? Absolutely not. I'm looking on the board over there and it says, patient cannot smoke in the room. Like, clearly you smoke and clearly those are your bag of potato chips over there. They throw these curveballs at you. I mean, you come in there and you're like, oh, you're in here for, I don't know, just a headache or something. You interview them when they're supposed to tell you. They don't mention any of that when you're doing the like exam or whatever, physical exam. You see all these scars all over them and stuff. You're like, well, what are these for? 10 years out from having brain cancer. Oh, I had like 9 heart attacks, stomach cancer, diabetes, and they've had like 8 strokes. I had cancer like 7 times and like, and 10 heart attacks. Wow. Why aren't they just honest with us? I have no idea. That's the kind of stuff that like when I'm in there with my classmates, we're just like, man. Overall, second year's just been, it's been like reality check. Like, you know, we're about to be 30 years here, thrown in the hospital. Hopefully we're paying attention. Hopefully. So I thought my biggest concern was gonna be my attending asking a question that I didn't know. But it turns out that's actually okay, but you have to know where to find it. So my biggest concern is not being able to find what it is that they want me to know. I feel like our school's prepared us pretty well for it, so. But we have to be moldable right now, if anything else, and we have been. We've had to be that. I feel good. I feel good. I might go for a little jog this afternoon, because I feel that good.